Welcome to Learn Commerce PU Online Classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello everyone, welcome to second PUC Statistics online classes. In the previous class we had discussed about importance of diagrams and graphs, general rules of diagrams and graphs and types of diagram. In that we also discussed various types of one dimensional diagram. In that first one is simple bar diagram. Okay, in this class we are going to discuss importance problems of simple bar diagram. Okay, let's see problem number 2, that is following figures represent the decadal changes of population of India. Draw simple bar diagram. See here observations are given like this. So here years are given and populations are given. So years are in the year 1901 the population was 238 million and in the year 1911 the population was 252 million. In the year 1921, the population was 251 million. Now, in the year 1931, the population was 278. Then next 1941, the population was 318. 1951, the population was 361. In the year 1961, the population was 439 million. In the year 71, the population was 548. 1981, that is 688 million. 1991, that population was 846 million. 2001, the population was 1028 million. And 2011, the population was 1210. Okay, these are the given observations. Okay, now you, for this I will draw simple bar diagram. So before drawing simple bar diagram we need to write title for this. And see here the question is like this: following figures represent the decadal changes of the population of India. Draw simple bar diagram. Therefore the title is simple bar diagram represents the decadal changes of population of India. So title is simple bar diagram represents the decadal changes of decadal change of population of India. Okay, this is the title. And see, this is x axis and this is y axis. Here x axis along with the year and y axis along with the population. Therefore, we need to take scale for y axis. Therefore, the scale is like this. That is 1 centimeter is equal to, I will take 200 units or 200 million. And see, this is origin and here y axis along with population. So here 1 centimeter is equal to 200 units. Therefore, this is 200, 400, 600, 800, next, yeah, yes, 200, 400, 600, 800, 1000, 1200 and 1400, 1600. Okay, I will stop here. Next. See the years, years are like this, 1901, 1911, 1921, okay, that observation I will write here. The first one is 1901, next 1911, 1921, 1931, 1941, 1951, 1951, 1951, 1961, 1971, 1981, 1981, 2001, the last one is 2011. These are the years. So here X axis along with year. See, in the year 1901, the population was 238 million. See, 200 is here, so 238 comes here. So here I will draw one bar diagram like this. So this bar represents the population in the year 1901. Okay, this bar diagram represents the population in 1901. Second year is 1911. See, 1911 is here and population is here. So population is here. Population was 252. So 200 is here. 400 is here. So 252 comes here. So here I will draw one bar diagram like this. Okay. So here I'll write here. So this shade indicates population. So this bar indicates population in 1911. Okay, next, in 1921 the population was 251. So 200 is here, 51 comes here. 251 comes here. And this bar indicates population in 1921. Okay, next, the year is 1931 and population was 278. So in 1931 population was 278 comes here, 208 comes here. So here I'll put one mark like this. So this bar indicates population in the year 1931. Next, 1941, the population was 318. So 400 is here, 300 comes here. So this bar indicates population in the year 1941. Okay, next, 1951, the population was 361. So 361 comes here. And this bar indicates population in the year 1951. Okay, next, 1961. So 1961 is here. So population was 439. So 400 is here, 39 comes here. Therefore the graph is like this. Bar is like this. So this bar indicates population in the year 1961. Okay, next, the year is 1971, and the population was 548. See, this is 400 and this is 600, then 548 comes here. Here this bar indicates population in the year 1971. Next, 1981. So population was 688. So see, 600 is here. So 688 comes here. This bar indicates population in the year 1981. Okay, next, 1991. The population was 846. See, 800 is here and 846 comes here. And this bar indicates population in the year 1991. And next, 2001. In the year 2001, population was 1028. See, 1000 is here and 1028 comes here. So here I will draw one bar diagram like this. So this bar indicates population in the year 2001. Okay, next, 2011. In the 2011, in the year 2011, population was 1210. See, 1000 is here, 1200 is here, 1210 comes here. So here I will draw one bar diagram like this. So this bar indicates population in the year 2011. Okay, this is all about problem number 2. Okay, next move to problem number 2. See, problem number, yeah, this is problem number 3, no? See, next move to problem number 3. The problem number 3 is represent the data regarding the population of different countries by simple bar diagram. See, here observations are given. The first column is country, another column is population. Here under country, China, India, USA, Indonesia, Brazil, Pakistan and Bangladesh are given. Under population, so the given populations are like this: 1341 million, 1210 million, 309 million, 238 million, 191 million, 185 million and 165 million. Okay, now using this observation, I will draw simple bar diagram like this. See, before drawing simple bar diagram, we need to write title for this. See, the question is like this: represent the data regarding the population of different countries by simple bar diagram. So the title is like this, that is, simple bar diagram represents the population of different countries. Simple bar diagram represents the population of different countries and the diagram is like this. This is x-axis and this is y-axis. See, here x-axis along with population and x-axis along with countries and y-axis along with population. See, here the populations are like this. Therefore, I will take the scale, that is y-axis. For y-axis, I will take the scale for y-axis. Here, 1 centimeter is equal to 200 units or 200 millions. So here I will take the origin is 0. So as I said earlier, y-axis along with population and scale is 1 centimeter is equal to 200. Therefore, this first one is 200, 400, 600, 800, 1000, 1200, 1400, 1600, 1800 and 2000. Okay, I will stop here. And see, here countries are like this. The first one is China, India, next USA, Indonesia, Brazil, okay, first one is China, India, USA, Indonesia, Next, Brazil, Pakistan. The last one is Bangladesh. So these are the countries. And see, in the country China, the population is 1341 million. In the country China, the population was 1341 million. See, 1200 is here and 1400 is here, and in here the population is 1341. See, 1341 comes here. Therefore, here I'll draw one bar diagram like this. This bar diagram indicates the population in the country China. Next, India. See, in India the population was 1210 millions. See, here India is here and 1200 is here. Here the population is 1210. See, 1210 comes here, and here I'll draw one bar diagram like this. And this bar indicates population in India. Okay, next country is USA. See, in USA the population is 309 million. See, 400 and here it is 200. 309 comes here. So this bar indicates the population in USA. Next, Indonesia. See, Indonesia is here, and in Indonesia the population is 238 million. See, 200 is here, 400 is here, 238 comes here. And this bar indicates population in Indonesia. Next, Brazil. In Brazil the population is 191 million. See, 200 is here, 0 is here, and 291 comes here. So this bar indicates population in Brazil. Next is Pakistan. In Pakistan the population is 185. So 200 is here, 0 is here, 185 comes here. So this bar indicates population in Pakistan. The last one is Bangladesh. In Bangladesh the population is 165 million. So 200 is here, 0 is here, 165 comes here. So this bar indicates population in Bangladesh. Okay, this is all about problem number 3. Okay, next move to problem number 4. So problem number 4 is like this, that is, the production of wheat are given below. Draw simple bar diagrams. So here given informations are year and production. So years are given like this: 2005, 2006, 2007, 2008, 2009 and 2010, and productions are 12, 15, 18, 19, 22 and 26. So here 12 in the sense 12 ton, 15 ton, 18 ton in 2007, 19 ton in 2008, 22 ton in 2009 and 26 ton in 2010. So these are the given informations. Here first we need to write title for this given information. So here title is, this is a question. The question is like this, that is, the production of wheat are given below, draw simple bar diagram. So here suitable title is, simple bar diagram represents the production of wheat. Therefore the definition is, simple bar diagram represents production of wheat. Okay, this is the title. Now I will draw a simple bar diagram. See, this is x axis and this is y axis. Here y axis along with production, and x axis along with year. See, here production is 12 ton, 15 ton, 18 ton productions are 12 ton, 15 ton, 18 ton, 19 ton, 22 tons and 26 tons. Therefore, the scale for y axis is, that is 1 centimeter is equal to 5 units. So origin is 0. Next, see here, 1 centimeter is equal to 5 units. Therefore, the value starts from 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 44. Okay, I will stop here. And see, so here y axis along with production and x axis along with year. See here, years are like this, that is 2005, 2006, 2007, 2008, 2009 and 2010. Okay, these are the years. See, in the year 2005, the production was 12 ton. See here, 12, see here it is 20 and here it is 15. 12 comes here. So, here I will draw one bar diagram like this. Here I will draw one bar like this. See, this bar indicates the the production of wheat in 2005. Next, in the year 2006, the production of paddy was 15 ton. See, 15 is here. So, here I will draw one bar like this. And this bar indicates the production of paddy in the year 2006. Next, in the year 2007, the production of paddy was 18 ton. See, in the year is here, 2007 is here. And see, this is 15 and this is 20 and 18 comes in between of this here. So, here I will draw one bar diagram like this. And this bar diagram indicates the production of wheat in the year 2007. Next, 2008, the year 2008, the production of paddy was 19 ton. So, 2008 is here and 920 is here. So, 19 comes here and so here I will draw one bar diagram like this, bar like this. So, this bar indicates the production of paddy in the year 2008. Next, in the year 2009, the production was 22 ton. See here, 20 is here, 25 is here and 22 comes here. So here I will draw one bar diagram like this. So this bar indicates population in the year 2009. Next, the last one, that is 2010. In the year 2010, the production was 26 tons. See here, 25 is here and 26 comes here. So, here I put one mark like this and this bar indicates production of wheat in the year 2010. Okay, this is all about problem number 4. Yes. Thank you for watching this video.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.